What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Axe Creation. We've received a lot of great feedback from my Adam Jones lessons, as well as the other Tool songs we've done, and I've received a lot of requests to do the song The Pop, so today we're going to take a look at that. I'll take you step by step through each one of the riffs, and then I'll play over the whole track so you can see all the parts in action. Now, the song starts off with vocals on the bass, and the guitar is going to swell in with an open chord. You can mix in some feedback if your amp is loud enough, and then you're going to go straight into the main riff of the song. Now, the main riff of the song is going to be used over the verses and mixed into the choruses. And let me play it for you, and then I'll try to explain it. So you have... Now, it could be a little tricky at first if you haven't played this before or you're not too familiar with it. And I guess the easiest way to explain this riff is you have your low D string, chugging open, and then you're going to play the octave higher. Now, you can play this note with your open D string, or you can grab it on the 5th fret of your A. Either one is right, the note's the same. You might notice that if you play the open D string, it's a little bit of a softer attack. Now, the way we're going to do this is you're going to play your low string twice, and then the upper octave, and then 3 times, and then the upper octave, and then 4 times. Now obviously we're going to put a little rhythm on that, so you have... So... Right? 2, 3, and 4. And then all you're going to do is pick out a power chord on the 3rd fret. Your low string and then your A string. And you can give that 5th string a little bit of a bend, give it some personality. Now after that, you're going to play your low string open. Then you're going to pull your string. You either play this on your D string 10th fret or A string 15th fret. Either way, you're going to be bending up to the octave of D. So you're going to let that ring out and then bend. And then once you hear the note hit the D, I would restrike that note. And then release the bend. So you're going to do that 4 times, and then the verse is going to kick in. And when the verse kicks in, you're going to lead that in with a little pick scrape, and then you're going to fade out for a little while, and then the verse starts. Now, as the verse is going on, if you listen real carefully, you're going to hear a very clean tone guitar. Play those notes, and you can play that on your B string, 13th fret, and 10th fret. You can kind of tremolo pick that if you want, and then, as well, you're going to have the... Repeat that bend note, and then a little, you can play that note. Listen real carefully, play what you hear, and play what feels good when you play it live. And then that's going to lead back into the main riff of the song. And then it leads to the chorus, and the chorus is going to take that same rhythm, but you're going to play chords over it. So you have 5th fret, 3rd fret, 10th fret. So you have the same rhythm. And then you're going to bring it down to the 5th fret and go 6, 5, 6, little tritone sound. The second time, you're going to go all the way down to that 1st fret. As you're playing the chorus riff, you're going to want to let those notes ring out with each other. Instead of cutting them off. If they ring out, it just sounds a little thicker, a little nicer. So after you play that... In that next verse, you're actually going to land on the 10th fret. those strings a little bit. Nice gradual bend. And when you do the pick scrape, I would throw on a lot of delay. Just helps fill up the sound. And then you're right back into that. And then you're going to repeat the chorus, jump back and forth. That whole part again. And then you're going to get, I guess you can call it a second chorus or a post-chorus, whatever you want to call it. And basically, you're going to move through these chords. You have your open D, and then the second fret, third fret, and fifth fret. And in between all those, you're going to have the same fill. You're going to have two dead notes, and then on your low D, you're going to hammer on 5-7, and then on your A string, 5-0, D string, 5-0. And you're going to move through all those chords. And you can do that twice. And then as you go through it again, you're just going to take out the fill and just play dead notes. This 5-8-3, and that's going to lead us to the breakdown of the song, which is kind of fun to play. So now we're up in 10th position, and you have a slight variation. The first time you're going to throw in a triplet, and then the second time is just going to be your old 16th notes. So we have open, open, and then 10-12, 12-12, power chord shape. And you're going to do that four times. Now, if you listen to the track, what comes next, he's going to harmonize that. Now, you can play this a couple different ways. He plays it different live. Play what sounds best for you, but this is what I do to make it sound what I think sounds good when I play it live or with the album. So I'm going to put the triplet on the 10th fret. Then I'm going to shift that up a minor third up into 13. And then I'm going to shift that back down, throw in the triplet again. And then in eighth position without the triplet. So you're going to do that two times as well. So you have, I'm going to play the whole all together. Release your palm mute, swell in a little bit, and you're going to remove the triplet as well. So you're going to have this. And you should build up that riff, and then it's going to open up, and you have this nice bridge riff, which is really great. And now the way the bridge riff works is you're going to play it four times, but the first two times are going to be different from the second two times. And this is a great example of how Jones uses slight variation in his riffs. He plays a different, slightly different each time through. So I'm going to play the first two times and the second two times the same. And if you want to change it up or you hear something different, feel free. So what we're going to do is you're in 10th position, same riff as the bridge. 10 to 12, and then 12-12. You're going to pick out a chord on the 8th fret. And then open. 5-7 power chord shape, and grab the 8th fret of your low string. Now from there, the second half, you're going to slide up to 10th position, and then Then you're going to add in a little inverted minor third shape. Five on your D, seven on your, five on your A, seven on your D, and then slide up. And same ending as the first few times. 8-8, 5-7-8. That sounds like. That's going to take us right into the climax, really cool breakdown riff. And it's actually the opening bass riff of the song. So you have this. Now the way that works, you have some open chugs and you're going to mix in 10 and 12. And then you're going to step up to 13. And then at the end of that, to turn around, you're going to throw in that triplet riff that he likes to use in Jambi and a couple other songs, where you pull off on your low string and then play your A string open, or you can mute your A string, whatever you prefer. It sounds very much like a tom roll. So you have. Like that. And you're going to pull off all those. Now you're going to play that riff five times. Alright, I'm not going to play it all five times. You can see that when we play along with the song. Alright, so after the breakdown riff, we're going to have a little open string chug, hammer on in third position, kind of break down the climax riff. And the way that's going to work is we're going to chug on our open string. And then we're going to go 3-5, 3-5. So let me play that slow so you can hear it. And then you're going to kind of repeat that rhythm and then throw a little pinch harmonic, 5th fret of your D string, A string. Like that. So that together you have. Then you're going to repeat that measure. And then there, you're going to have a little hammer on 3 to 5 in your A string. And now the fill is going to match the drum fill. And what I like to do is a bunch of hammer-ons on your D and A string, 3-5, and then add your triplet on your D. So you do it on your D string, 0-3-5, A string, D string, A string. Like that, so you have. Out. Let me play that whole little section for you so you can see what it sounds like. Alright, so after we finish the breakdown of those chug riffs, we're going to repeat a few things. We're going to repeat the verse riffs and the chorus riffs, and as well as the second chorus. And when we get to the second chorus, we're actually going to cut one of the phrases off. So you have the first two phrases, and then just the chord part of it. Same way it led into the bridge, except now we're going to go into the outro riff, which is one of my favorite all-time Tool riffs. We have a couple similar shapes. We have a minor third shape on the 5th fret, so it's 5-7. Then you move that down to the 3rd position, 3-5. And then you're going to go power chord on the 3rd fret, so it's 3-3-5. And then 6th position, 8-6. And you have. We'll be right back. basically how you play that. You play 5, and then double up the 7 with an open. And then do the same thing. So you do that back and forth, then you're gonna go A and D. Give a little slide up to the 8th position. And then repeat. So you're gonna do that twice. Then you're gonna, on the third time, take out the 16th notes, give it a little more groove, and then bring back the 16th notes for the fourth time. So you have. I love the fact how it ends a half step above the root, giving you some sort of false cadence. So there you go. There are all the parts in the pot. So I'm going to play along with the song now so you can see all of them in action. And I hope this helps. Until then, I'll see you next time. Thanks a lot.
Who are you to wave your finger? You must have been out your...